Hey guys, HappyMonkey here with some Twitch and Minecraft news. So as I said in my last Minecraft news episode, we are getting Twitch with Minecraft now, and it's a phenomenal thing. It's absolutely awesome. If you want to stream, it's going to be really easy to do. I'm still in two minds about if it's a good thing or a bad thing, considering you're going to have a load of like 6-year-olds streaming Minecraft because they just can, and it'll just oversaturate Twitch a little bit. But at least I can stream to you guys, and at least a lot of the big YouTubers will be able to stream without any issues and without any third-party programs. So a little bit more news to add towards this. It won't impact your game in any way if you're not streaming. It basically doesn't go through some tweets that Dinnerbones tweeted out. So it won't impact your game if you're not streaming. While streaming, obviously it will, but less than a third-party streaming tool. So it'll be, you know, you'll have a little bit of lag maybe, but you won't have as much as if you were using a third-party program like Wirecast or OBS or something like that. It'll be less laggy than if you did it with a third-party program like that. Other things include, there will be mic and system volume options, so you can obviously have the mic from your computer or your headset, and also you can have the computer audio as well. They're two different things. There is also a hotkey to stop, start, pause the stream. Also running, commercials, so there's a run commercial button. If you're a partner on Twitch, you can just run a commercial like you do with a normal Twitch at the moment. There is also advanced settings to tweak quality, as well as a list of Twitch servers to send to with bandwidth tests, so you know which one's the best one for you. So you can, seriously, this implementation of Twitch is going to be phenomenal. We've got loads of cool settings in it. It's going to be really, actually mind-blowingly awesome when it comes out. So, the stream will adjust accordingly, and no impact to your viewers. Basically, how Minecraft will compensate if you change the window size while streaming and stuff like that, the stream will adjust accordingly, so it won't impact any of the viewers. It's actually kind of cool looking, so according to Dinnerbone. So I'm looking kind of forward to seeing how that looks and how that all works. Another thing is the version number. Now, a lot of people are wondering when it's going to be coming out. Will we see it in 1.8? Will we see it in 1.7.3? Well, the response to this is we are going to see it in 1.7.3. So that means the next full version of Minecraft will have the Twitch streaming, guys. You don't have to wait until 1.8. You're going to get it sooner than that. It's going to be amazing. So, Dinnerbone's hoping to have a snapshot out later this month, so we could see the first implementation of Twitch streaming in a 1.7.3 snapshot later this month. So keep your eyes peeled for that. Of course, when it comes out, I will be doing a review of it, and just so you guys can obviously have all the information. There will be a someone asked, is there going to be a Linux version? They've tested it's tested and confirmed working on Mac and Windows right now, but we'll see. They'll see about a Linux version coming in the coming weeks. So hopefully they're going to have a Linux version in the coming weeks. If you're a Linux user, do not worry. They are working on it. It's just a little bit of time to obviously code it for Linux as well. So it's working on Mac, it's working on Windows, as far as the tests have gone so far. But Linux, they're still working out the bugs. But there will be a Linux version in the coming weeks. So stay tuned for that. There might be some news for you Linux users out there. So, I mean, guys, this, once again, what do you think about this? Do you think it's going to be a great thing? Do you think it's a bad thing? I mean, personally, as I say, I love the fact I'm going to stream to you guys really easily. And I love the fact that I'm going to be able to just, like, click a button. Hey, guys, I'm streaming. Go and watch it. And you'll be able to do that. I love the fact that all the big YouTubers can stream really easily. I mean, as a Mac user myself, there are no third-party programs out there for streaming. That's, you know, you've got Wirecast, which costs over about £400 or $400. And that's ridiculous. Then your only other option really is Flash, and like the Flash Broadcaster. Flash Broadcaster is not the greatest. It requires other three programs to make it work. You know, got like your sound option programs, you've got your streaming programs, you've got your screen capture programs. All these things required. It's ridiculous. So with Minecraft implementing this, for me, amazing. I'm going to be able to just stream to you guys really easily. Now, there is no word of a webcam functionality yet. This has not been mentioned. I think Martin and the Littlewood, he did ask Dinnerbone, but Dinnerbone didn't get back to him on that one as far as I'm aware. So as far as we're aware at the moment, there is no face cam functionality. But I imagine, and I could be wrong here, but I imagine as soon as 1.7.3 comes out and the Twitch ability is implemented, there will be people out there already working on a mod which will implement the face cam feature. If not that, if Mojang themselves haven't. So I wouldn't worry about First Camp too much. There is a chance that, you know, there's going to be a mod for it. We already had a mod out there for Twitch itself, and it was great. I used it in the past myself. It's a great mod. But it's nice to see that Dinnerbone and all the Mojang guys implementing it as an actual feature now. And they do that a lot with mods. They find a mod that people really enjoy, and then they try and improve on it, and they create their own version with improvements, obviously. I mean, this is going to have loads of advanced settings that Dinnerbone is excited about, and I hope we all are as well, because advanced settings mean a lot more functionality, a lot more customization, and a lot more abilities to give towards the user to actually pass on towards the end user, which would be like the viewer itself. So, I mean, as I said, what do you guys think? Tell me in the comments. Do you think it's a good idea, bad idea? Are you looking forward to it? Are you not looking forward to it? Do you want to see a load of six-year-olds streaming? Hey, guys, I'm doing a stream today. Look at my thing. Do you like that? Do you not like that? Do you think there should be some sort of setting now in Twitch where you can have, like, you know, advanced streams and then, you know, lesser ones? I mean, sure, we have the partner system at the moment, but not everyone can be partner. I mean, you know, it takes a long time. So, hey, tell me in the comments. Tell me down there. There is a big section, brand new comment system by Google+. I hate it, but still, it's a big comment section. Go and comment there and let me know. And I read all my comments, guys. I read them all. I may not be able to reply to all of them these days. I used to be able to reply to every single comment because I had a few of them. Now I get a lot more, and it's quite hard to actually comment back to everyone. But I do read every comment. So if you want to comment, comment below, and I will definitely read it, even if I don't get back to you guys straight away or at all. But I'm terribly sorry about that. It just takes time. So until next time, TTYL, peace out, and bye-bye. If you enjoyed, well, that was a weird bye-bye. If you enjoyed, please show a like, share, comment, and subscribe. And I'll see you guys later. TTYL, bye. Ah, I've already said it, bye. Bye, guys. Oh, I keep saying bye. I should stop saying bye so much. I don't want to say bye. I love you guys. Bye.